next to you and reads the newspaper over your shoulder. Wait, don't turn the page, I'm not finished. Life is so uncertain. Here I am. Yes, it's me. Take my hand and you'll see. Here I am. Yes, it's true. All I want, girl, is you. Woo-hoo! Given the true intellectual and emotional compatibility are at the very least difficult, if not impossible, to come by, we could always opt for the more temporal gratification of sheer physical attraction. That wouldn't make you a shallow person, would it?
Here I am. Yes, it's me. Take my hand and you'll see.
Chevrolet, what Dodge is to Chrysler, what Corn Flakes are to Post Toasties, what the clear blue sky is to the deep blue sea, what Hank Williams is to Neil Armstrong. Can you doubt we were made for each other?
Here I am. Yes, it's me.
Too little, too late. I realize there are things you say and do you can never take back. But what would you be if you didn't even try? You have to try. So after a lot of thought, I'd like to reconsider. Please, if it's not too late, make it a cheese burger.
Here I am.
dogs inside. Well, Joe Biden's chicken, 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 till the sun goes down. I'm gonna choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken, till the sun goes down. And now the rooster, he dove on the ground. He told the man his angels out of town. To say, you told the rooster you can fly away. Choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken till the sun goes down. I'm gonna choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken,
choke my chicken till the sun goes down. Dance around the outside, baby, till we're Cinderella, and I'll be a cowboy man, and I can roll her on the bed, and I can ride her on the bed, and she'll be my Cinderella, and I'll be a cowboy man, and I can roll her on the bed, and I can ride her on the bed, and she'll be my Cinderella.
Folks are great. What a beautiful place this is. You've got.
Yeah!
And the best thing about it is you've got to want to come here to get be able to find it. You know, driving in Florida. Is a pleasure because people. Florida is one place where people really know how to drive. This is a song I made about driving around my hometown, Houston, Texas. If you ever decide to do that yourself,
no.
Be very careful.
Short as a minute, she's a pretty little thing, with everything in her style. the door, just sit around and watch it snow. It's morning.
Thank you.
Texas, Keith Sewell. On cello from Austin, Texas, John Hagen. And on drums from Los Angeles, the one and only Russ Kunkel.
I know people come to come to the Magnolia Festival. They come from all over the world, but Florida, is one of those countries like where I'm from. Sometimes it's rare to meet somebody who's originally from that place. We have to stick together. That's right. When I was in high school, some of my best friends in high school were from far away and strange places with names like Massachusetts and New Jersey and New York, even Pennsylvania. At first, we were skeptical of those folks, but after a while, we realized, it was all right because we knew we couldn't do anything about it.
I was born and raised in Texas. It means so much to me. And oh my girl, comes from down in Georgia. We were up in Tennessee, and as we were driving down the highway, she asked me, baby, what's so great? How come you're always going on about the long story? That's right, you're not Texas. Won't you get away? That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas, won't you get away? On the road, it looked so lovely. She stood there on the side, and she grew smaller in my Carolina. Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere.
Won't you let me help you, mister? Just pull your hat down the way I do and buy your pants just a little longer. And next time somebody laughs at you, you just tell them you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. Texas won't you anywhere. That's right. Like my baby.
but nobody knows me like my bee. Nobody holds me. Nobody knows me. Nobody knows me like my pain. I like cream in my coffee. Nobody knows me like my Such a stranger, why don't you just go on home? Well, I hours and minutes where I'm headed to. You couldn't stop me if you knew what to do. And I left and I planned to go alone. But the road was long and home was far, so I stopped off this little cowboy looking for a walk through the door. She just smiled, pulling a long ponytail and a pretty white dress. She said, "Ah, bull riders do it best." I said, "Oh my God, what's your name?" "My name's Locke." And I said, "Take your boots and walk out of Manhattan." And I said, "Ooh, goodbye, my heart. I can't be no cowgirl every day." And I looked at her and she looked at me, and I looked back and she looked back, and we went out together, oh, oh. Eyes were bright just like the stars, but you drove a pickup, said you hated cars, but loved to ride around out at the dark. And I said, "Ooh, get back to my heart, take your boots and walk out of my life." And I said, "Ooh, get back to my heart, baby, I can't be no cowgirl every day." And she cooks the supper and I try to pay the rent. But I'm a traveling man, don't tie me down. There's just too much living going all around. But I can't figure out what went. Then I think, "Ooh, get back to my heart, take your boots and walk out of my life." And I think, "Ooh, get back to my heart, I can't be no cow."
This is a song from our very first album that came out back in 1986, and it's one that I made up really just to try to be funny, but people took it serious, which I'm grateful for, you know. And it's proof that you can make a song up about anything. And I made it up while I was mowing my parents' yard. So you can make a song up about anything, doing just about anything. So keep that in mind.
That's the difference between God and me. God does, but I don't. God will, but I won't.
That's the difference.
Between God and me.
Sunday, and I noticed that in a lot of the campers, a lot of the tents out in the campground, people had their widescreen already for the big games. This is a song that I made up. Was really inspired by a beer commercial that was playing in a football game.
Don't you
know
my wife?
Oh, I forgot about that thing.
They always have the best beer commercials in, on the football game. It was a beautiful day, much like today here was down in Houston. These cold snaps don't come along very often in our part of the world, in our horizontality. It was just one of those, not a cloud in the sky, perfect carefree kind of day. And I was watching this beer commercial, laughing just to myself. I was all alone in my living room, having a wonderful time. After this beer commercial, just before the game started up again, there was a commercial for the evening news, which was about to come on after the game. And the tone of the difference between the beer commercial and the commercial for the evening news was sort of striking to me. The contrast to that, because on the evening news, there was footage of some of our young men and young women in the Middle East. It struck me that while I was having a carefree Sunday afternoon, they were doing anything but having a carefree Sunday afternoon. And in fact, were the reason that I was able to have a carefree Sunday afternoon. So I started thinking about how we started out and how far we've come and how much we owe to those young men and young women. And at the very least, we owe our greatest responsibility to them is to do the best we can in our own lives over here.
subject to the natural forces. Home is where my horse is.
All the day.
day on, and I drove on through the night, and I thought of her waiting for the beaters, but she cried, and the lights of L.A. County, they look like diamonds in the sky, as I drove at the altar, or just in her gown. Lord, her face was bright as the stars are shining, like I dreamed of all my life. And they kissed each other, and they turned around, and they saw me standing.
Personal heroes, and certainly one of my musical heroes. I grew up listening to him in Houston, when I finally got to meet Guy on some trips to Nashville, everything since that has just been icing on the cake. You know, hearing Rodney Crowell tonight was just wonderful. It always makes me think of Guy because I know Rodney because of Guy. And I felt really honored to get to take part in a Guy Clark tribute record, which came out a couple of years ago. This is a song that we did from. It's from Guy's album, Texas Cooking.
Run. oh, the back door.
Some lyrics around an old fiddle tune I've been playing for a long time.
Would you be willing to do that for us?
I'd love to.
Ladies and gentlemen, Luke Bullock.
Thank you. Well, here's one that Guy and I got to write with another one of my favorite singer-songwriters in Nashville, a guy named John Randall Stewart, who wrote some lyrics around an old fiddle tune I've been playing for years and years. This one's called The Temperance Reel.
I sure like good liquor, it makes me wanna play. Funny thing about the fiddle is it makes you wanna drink. For a shot of homemade whiskey and $100 bill, I'll burn the hair right off of this boat playing the temperance reel. I'll play one for the ladies, so sweet they swoon and sway. I've left it the one that got away. I've played it in the mountains and out on the western plains. I play it for my brother who I'll never see again. Play it high, play it lonesome like a mountain whippoorwill. Let's burn the rosin off this boat and play the temperance reel. An awful, dreadful sin. Then I know where I'm going, soon as I know where I've been. This old fiddle bit me on the leg when I was 6 years old. I guess I'm gonna play it till the devil gets my soul. Well, I can play it all night long, never get my fill. Let's lay that rhythm down, boys, play the temperance reel. Thank you.
But you have a solo recording out right now, right?
I do, yeah. I made my first solo EP a couple of years ago.
And is Temperance Real on that recording?
It is not on that recording.
What?
It'll be on my next recording.
But do you have plans to go in the recording studio?
I do. I'm hoping to get in the studio within the next couple of months and start working on my next record.
And you're hoping to?
Some tentative plans.
Well, we hope you do too. For any of us on stage or out in the audience who might want to look up your current recording, could you tell us the name of it?
Well, sure. It's a self-titled EP. It's called Luke Bullen.
That is a wonderful name. Keith Sewell has a new record out as well. Keith, would you mind telling us what it's called?
Yeah, it's called Let Me Fall.
And can your record be found?
Yes, sir. It can be found out there somewhere.
Out there.
Out there.
Out there.
Up in the internet air.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Let Me Fall, Keith Sewell.
Stops, nobody knows. Every day that I've been gone, I wonder if it goes to your room. Just count the minutes one by one.
Something that you love to do every day of your life. You know, I've been lucky to be in that position, unbelievably to myself, getting to do something that I would do for fun, you know, for a living. And not only do I get to do something I love to do, I get to do it with my closest and most talented friends. And life just doesn't get any better than that. You know, where I grew up, where I come from, playing, you know, making stuff up and playing and singing is not a job. And, but you know, I never really wanted a job. I just wanted to be able to make stuff up and play and sing. So thinking about, you know, what to do for real was a kind of a hard thing for me. So and that's where this song came from. It was the idea of a sort of the idea was a, you know, a child trying to think about what he wanted to be when he grows up, and finally he decides that he's. Doesn't have to decide. He wants to be everything. He's going to be a cowboy out west and the captain of a great ship all at the same time.
Just
that I just couldn't live without a woman's charm. And even though she loves the smell of French perfume, and even though she walks around in high-heeled shoes, well, all I know is I'm the one who pays her price. Man, she's no lady, she's my wife. Texas, they polished up their guns.
this song for all the fellas out there, all the fellas in the happy couples that are out there, and who realize the reason they're in a happy couple is it's the love of a good woman. And the direction that we get. Because Lord knows all us fellas need as much help as we can get. It's a good woman who realizes that her man wants to do the right thing. He just has absolutely no idea what that is.
No.
Luke Bullock, John Hagen, Victor Krause, and Russ Conklin.
Well, I went to church last Sunday so I could sing and pray. Something quite unusual happened on that day. The church started right on time, like it does without a doubt. And everything was all just fine, except when it came time to let us out. The old preacher, he kept preaching. He told us, I have one more thing to say, children, before you think of leaving. He said, think about the judgment day. Everyone got nervous, because everyone was hungry too. And everyone was wondering what was the next thing he would do. The preacher, he kept preaching.
Preach.
He said, now I remind you, if I meet you all, better pay attention. I might decide to preach all day. Everyone was getting so hungry. The old one started feeling ill, and the weak one started passing out. The young ones, they could not sit still, and the preacher's voice rose. I snuck up to the balcony, and I went into the choir. And I said, brothers, sisters, help me, please. I said, I give you a signal. When I raise up my hand, won't you please join me together? Praise the Lord, I have a plan. The preacher, he kept preaching. As long as the struggle hard to fight, Father, please forgive me. And I stood up and with all my might sang to the Lord that praises be. It's time for dinner now, let's go. Listen to what the preacher said, to the Lord that praises me. It's time for dinner now, let's go. I did give the signal, and I raised up my hands. Join me in the choir, whatever woman, child, and man. Sing to the Lord that praises me. It's time for dinner now, let's go. Got some beans and some good cornbread. Listen to what the preacher said. Listen to the Lord that praises me. It's time for dinner now, let's go. The preacher, he stopped preaching, and a hush the church did fill. And then a great white dove from up above landed on the windowsill. And the dove flew down beside him, and a fork appeared right in his hand. And everybody watched him. He just ate that bird right there. And then now, everyone got really nervous. And he did start to glow, and as we watched on in disbelief, these were the words he spoke.
My wife's in the kitchen, she's been there all day. I know she's cooking something good to buy your head to pray.
He sang to the Lord that praise be. It's time for dinner now, let's go. It's time for dinner now, let's go. And the moral of this story, the truth, it is plain the truth. God knows if a preacher preaches long enough, even he'll get hungry too. To the Lord that praises me. It's time for dinner now, let's go. We got some beans, some good cornbread. Listen to what the preacher said. Now to the Lord that it's time for dinner now, let's go. We got some beans, some good cornbread.
Thank you.
know, this is our very first time that we get to come to the Magnolia Festival, and it's our first time really to play in this part of Florida. So thank you all for bringing us.
I'm feeling so blue, I don't know what to do, because I'm head over heels in love with you. Change my notion, I just got to forget you if I can.
I'm feeling so blue, I don't know what to do, cause I'm head over heels in love with you.
Thank you all very much.